Hi guys, in this lesson, we're going to look at host-based security for Amazon EC2. And specifically, we're going to look at Amazon Inspector, and we're going to look at a couple of the features of Systems Manager. So I'm in the console, and the first thing I'm going to do is go to IAM. Now we're going to launch a couple of EC2 instances in a moment. But first, we're going to create a role to use for their instance profile so they have permissions for Systems Manager. So I'm going to go to Role, and I'm going to create a role. The use case is going to be EC2. Click on Next. And we need to find a permissions policy. Now, if I just type SSM and hit Enter, we'll see we get a few results here. Now, the first one is the one that we used to use. So this is Amazon EC2 role for SSM. Let me just bring it up the screen a bit. Now, if I click on the plus, we can see the policy statement. There's lots of permissions to Systems Manager, Systems Manager messages we've got here, EC2. And then if we go down, you can see some CloudWatch and some CloudWatch logs permissions and a few more. So that's the one we used to use. It's been deprecated. So what you should use now is this one. So they do put a note here in the description to say, instead, you should be using the SSM managed instance core policy. And that's this one here. So let's have a look. Some of the same permissions for Systems Manager. And it looks a little bit lighter. There's a few permissions that are different to the EC2 role for SSM, but that's the one we should be using. So I'm going to select that policy, click on Next. Let's give this role a name. I'll call it EC2 role for SSM. We can see that EC2 is going to be able to assume this role through the trust policy. So that's good. Let's create the role. So the role's been created. Now let's go to EC2. For this exercise, I'm going to launch two EC2 instances. The first one will be the Amazon Linux 2 AMI. So I'm just going to click through this one. Now, the Linux 2 AMI will actually have the Systems Manager agent installed. We're going to use T2 Micro. Now, we're going to leave most of the defaults here. The only thing we need to change is under role, I'm going to use my EC2 role for SSM. Now, in this case, I'm actually going to select the default security group. Now, my default security group doesn't really have much going for it. It doesn't have any rules for allowing, for instance, port 22 secure shell. It doesn't allow remote desktop protocol. It doesn't allow remote PowerShell or any other ports. So it only allows traffic within the security group itself. So it allows anything from other EC2 instances in the same security group. Now we are going to look at Systems Manager Session Manager. So what I want to demonstrate is how Sessions Manager allows us to access these instances despite the fact that we don't have any ports for remote PowerShell or SSH. So let's go through review and launch. I'm going to create a new key pair and then launch my instance. Great, so that one's going. Now let's go back, and this time we're going to launch an instance of Windows. So I'm going to scroll down to Microsoft Windows Server 2019 base. Now this also has the Systems Manager agent installed. So let's just go through to configure our instance, select our role for SSM. Now the same, we're going to use an existing security group, and it's going to be the default security group. So let's launch this instance. And now we have our two instances launching. The next thing I'm going to do is head over to Amazon Inspector. On the main splash screen, I need to choose Get Started. Now it is possible to delegate to specific accounts. We're just going to enable Inspector. You can view the role permissions here. So this is for a service linked role that Inspector will need to get the permissions it requires to scan your environment. So you can see there's various permissions here for Direct Connect, EC2, load balancing, network firewall, and so on. So let's just enable Inspector. So there we go, Inspector is enabled and our first scan is underway. Now it can take quite some time to bring back any information, any findings in the console here. So you might need to leave this running for some time. Make sure your instances are running in the free tier and you've got enough allocation, and then you can leave them running if you want to actually see some results. Now, what should be a bit faster is Systems Manager. So we're going to head over there now. So with Systems Manager, there's a couple of important things to note. Firstly, our instances must have the Systems Manager agent installed. And then secondly, we need to make sure that our instances have the permissions required to be able to send information to Systems Manager. And that's what we've already done with our instance profile and the policy that we applied. So now we can click on Get Started with Systems Manager. And we want to run through this quick setup. So I'm just going to choose my region. I'm keeping it on US East 1 and then get started. Now you can see the various different types of configuration. And the one that I'm going to choose here is to create host management. So this enables us to manage our EC2 instances. So I'm choosing create. And then you can see that there's various options for how you configure the systems manager. So the agent can be updated every couple of weeks. You can collect inventory every 30 minutes if you want to, and scan instances for missing patches daily. So I'm going to leave those enabled. You can also install and configure the CloudWatch agent and have that updated as well. You then have the option of enabling Systems Manager for the entire organization, custom, where you get to choose the organizational units in AWS organizations and then the regions where you would like to enable it, or just choose current account. So I'm going to choose current account and current region, and I'm going to leave it on all instances. You could then filter by tags or resource groups or some kind of manual configuration. I'll leave it to all instances, and let's create. And this may take a few minutes to complete. And that just took a few minutes, and now the quick setup has completed. So let's go and see what it's found. If we go into inventory, we can see that inventory is enabled on our managed instances. And we can see that we have some inventory information that has come back. So for example, we can see that we have two different operating system versions in operation at the moment. And then you can see some information about the applications and the server roles and so on. So inventory is pulling quite a bit of configuration information from your instances. Now, what I also want to do is go to Session Manager. So we're going to look at how we can use Session Manager to connect to our instances. Let's choose Start Session. And we can see we've got two instances running here. So let's first start with the Windows instance, which is the top one, and click on Start Session. So there we have it. I've got command line access now. And if I run ipconfig, I can see my instance has the IP address 172.31.82.141. So that should correspond to one of my instances here. And sure enough, it's the bottom instance, my Windows instance. If you go back to Session Manager, and what we're going to do is start a session, and I'll show you how to connect to your Linux instance as well. So I'm just going to choose my Linux instance, click on Start Session, and now we should get SSH access to our EC2 instance. So now we have command line access to our Linux instance, and if I run ifconfig, we can see that we've got the IP address that finishes with 187, and that should correspond to my Linux instance here in EC2, and it does. So that's how you can actually access your instances securely from the command line using Session Manager without actually having any security group rules that are allowing this access. We just need the agent, we need the EC2 instance to have permissions to Systems Manager, and then we can make these secure connections without exposing any ports. Now back in Session Manager, there are some preferences here. You can go in and enable logging with CloudWatch logs and actually stream the information into a log group. You can enable S3 logging as well and a few other things. So next, let's go down to Patch Manager. Here we can click on Patch Now or Configure Patching or have a look at the baselines. If you configure patching, this is where you can do things like patch based on tags, patch groups, or manual selection of your EC2 instances. You can configure a schedule with maintenance windows and you know what the patching operations are. And you can even do more advanced things like configuring a certain amount of resources to be patched at any one time from a group. We're not going to do that. We're just going to go back to the main screen here and click on Patch Now. Let's choose Scan and Install and allow the reboot option. And I'm going to leave the instances to patch set to all instances and just patch now. So Systems Manager will now scan these instances to see if there are any patches that need to be installed. And if there are, it's going to go ahead and install those patches. And that just took a couple of minutes to complete. And now we have our execution summary. And we can see that it is a successful scan and install operation. If you want some more detail, you can click on the execution ID, and you can then look at the output associated with that particular operation. Now, this scan must have been on the Linux instance because we can see that the precondition of the operating system being Windows was not fulfilled. So let's check the other one, and we should see a different output. So in this case, we can see that there were some patches downloaded and installed. Now let's go back to Amazon Inspector, and we can see that there is some information now that's showing. We can see that there are potentially some risk-based remediations we might need to perform. And if we on the left here choose vulnerability, we can see that we have one high status vulnerability, and that's a common vulnerabilities and exposures with a certain ID here related to OpenSSH. If you choose by instance, it's then going to show you the instances that are affected, in this case, the Amazon Linux 2 instance. You can also look at findings by container image if you're running containers, or by repository if you're using ECR. So that's it for this particular hands-on lesson. I will go now and terminate my instances, so make sure that once you finish with them, you do the same.